Colonial militia were called in times of emergency. Sounds like there's something going on right now. If the British came or a Native American attack on the frontier, these guys were called up. They're not soldiers, they're regular citizens, but they did take up arms and try to protect our rights. Gotta go.
Slashed and torn. It's a musket. He's got a lot of pull.
It's a musket. Months,
so. Oh, yeah. No, he's probably, you know, he wants to get outside.
Oh, he does. He does. He's all about it.
You want to take a look? It's not going to go up. It's not going to go bang. It'll be across me already. That's it. So this is called a flint. That's a piece of flint. That's why it's called a flint lock. So what happens is if there's gunpowder in this pan and this thing hits that, it's called a hammer with a jaw, and that's called a piece of flint. This is a prison plate. It hits up against here, causes spark. That spark goes through that little hole, and it explodes the powder down the barrel. So that's what allows this thing to go boom, right? So that's why it's called a flint lock, right? You know that in seventh grade. Hopefully they go over something like that. But it weighs about 10 pounds, pretty heavy. You want to feel it? You can hold it, it's not gonna. That's heavy, right? Yeah. And that holds a bayonet. It's a triangular shaped bayonet. It was outlawed right before World War I. They don't use these in combat anymore, but they're designed to stab and then twist it, and that causes a wound that can't be sewn up. So that'll take that guy out of the fight. Probably gonna die of infection after that as well. Nasty weapon. It fires a 75 caliber round lead ball.
That's going to be my next question. What happens?
75 caliber. Wow. That's a big slug. And when that hits human flesh, it expands, hits bone, cracks it, destroys it. So it'll go in one size, and then on the other side of your body. Especially short range. So I fired about 2 weeks ago. We fired round balls down to live rounds. And I was hitting stuff at 25 yards. Pretty good, you know, but anything beyond 50, it's just, you know, that's why they're lining up. Now, today we kept our space because of COVID. We usually were. Now, the militia guys, they're not real soldiers, you know, that's why I ran. I don't know if you noticed.
Yeah.
So I was like, they're crazy. But militia guys are just called up for, you know, emergencies, you know. So they're regular guys, you know.
Locally.
Yeah, they're local guys. Like, crazy. I'm going up against the British, you know. But it's nice to meet you guys, okay?
Hey, thank you all very much. Have a good weekend.
I see ya.
Just want to say thank you for organizing this, having us here tonight. Went through a lot of work, a lot of trouble. So after you come here, we'll do the thing we do. So three cheers for Adam. Hip hip.
Huzzah!
Hip hip.
Huzzah!
Hip hip.
Huzzah!
Job commanding us today. By inspiration, he got the job done. So, three cheers for Captain Watts. Hip hip.
Huzzah!
Hip hip.
Huzzah!